हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू FLClouds.com लर्न टू लीड। माय नेम इज सौनभ भार्गव एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस बैंकिंग अवेयरनेस टॉप एमसीक्यूज फ्रॉम द मंथ ऑफ जनवरी 2021। सो दिस सेशन विल बी इन इंग्लिश, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द सेशन। सो यू ऑल नो अबाउट अ न्यू प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ FLClouds, कैरियर क्लाउड्स लर्न टू लीड। इट्स अ प्ले स्टोर ऐप, यू कैन डाउनलोड इट फ्रॉम द गूगल प्ले स्टोर। So what you can avail from this app, so you will get daily current affairs for banking and insurance, SSC, railway and UPSC civil service examination. So what you need to do, you have to download the app, you have to log in with Google, and daily you will get current affair updates with daily quizzes. Means if you want to evaluate your performance, how many current affairs you can retain in your mind. So after daily current affairs, you will also get the quiz which you can attempt on daily basis, and even after the week also you will get top MCQs from the week in quiz form. The next here is Crack Current Affairs 2021 for Bank and Insurance in English. You will get the daily current affairs, daily quiz, even weekly current affairs, and even you will get the current affairs for the month. So in this way, under Career Clouds, you will get current affairs daily, you will get current affairs for the week, and you will also get current affairs on monthly basis. Means you can revise your current affair under a single platform regularly so that you can retain them for your examination. You can see the banking awareness part, banking awareness 2021 in English. I am going to cover in this session about the January 2021 current affairs from banking and economy sections. You will also get exam oriented PDF. For example, if SBI PO or clerk examination is approaching, so you will also get exam oriented PDF. You will get a special current affairs, for example, budget and economic survey. So you will get all the MCQs which will be covered from this particular topic, like recently budget was promulgated by the Finance Minister of India. So whatever important updates were there in current affairs, in the budget and economy survey, so you will also get the MCQs based questions so that you can revise yourself and prepare for your upcoming examination. You will get topic wise current affairs, 20 types of PDFs. So topic wise current affairs here means, for example, you know there are different sections in current affairs, national current affairs, international current affairs, banking and economy, obituary, sports, important days, books and authors. So you will also get the current topic wise current affairs after a month. You will get current affairs both in English as well as Hindi. If you are prepared for any state pieces examination, so you will get state wise current affairs, for example West Bengal. So if you are preparing for West Bengal PCS examination, UP PCS, Bihar PCS, so you can also avail the opportunity of state wise current affairs in the PDF format, and you can revise it before your examination. So if you like my session, so if you want to enroll the plus courses of FLClouds, so you have to download the Career Clouds app, and you can use my coupon code Bhargav10 for additional 10% discount. So it's a limited period offer, so you can buy it now. So let's start the session. So the first question here is, which organization released the report on trend and progress of banking in India 2019-20 that highlighted the performance of banking and allied sector? Means a report was released, the name is report on trend and progress of banking in India in 2019 and 20. It had highlighted the performance of a banking and the allied sector related with banking. So who has released the report? So the right answer here is Reserve Bank of India. Means it is released by the Reserve Bank of India. So let's see what this report says. So this report was released by Reserve Bank of India, and the name is Report on Trend and Progress of Banking in India in Financial Year 2019 and 2020. Now what this report shows, so it was released under the broad theme of impact of COVID-19 on banking and non-banking sector, because you know owing to COVID-19 there was a severe impact on the economy and banking owing to COVID-19. So this report is released based on that only, that what was the impact of COVID-19 on banking and non-banking sector, and what will be the way forward to improve it. Now, this report was submitted to the central government in terms of the section 36 subsection 2 of the Banking Regulation of Act 1949. So, Banking Regulation Act is very important for you because often it is asked in different examinations that when Banking Regulation Act was passed, so it is 1949. Now, this report presented the performance of banking and including the cooperative bank and non-banking financial companies also. Now, what is banking and what is non-banking financial institutes? Okay, you know about the Bajaj Finance, the Muthoot Finance. So, all these are non-banking financial companies. So, they are not banking, they are non-banking financial company. Now, let me tell you something about the Reserve Bank of India. You know, Reserve Bank of India was formed on 1st of April 1935. The governor is Shakti Kanta Das. He is the 25th governor of Reserve Bank of India. The headquarter, when RBI was established, it was located at Kolkata, and at presently it is located at Mumbai, Maharashtra. So, in 1937, it was shifted to Mumbai, Maharashtra. Apart from one governor of RBI, there are four deputy governors who used to work with the governor. So the name of four deputy governors are Bibhu Prasad Kanungo, Mahesh Kumar Jain, and Michael Devabrat Patra and M. Rajeshwar Rao. Michael Devabrat Patra and M. Rajeshwar Rao are very important for you because they are appointed few months back only. So all these are important updates from this news. Let's move to the next question. The next question here is, which was the only authorized bank in India to issue electoral bond as on December 2020? Now the question here is, what is electoral bond? You know about the political donation which is made by different industrialists before different citizens of India to the political parties for election. So you can make the donation in the form of electoral bond. So who can issue a bank which is authorized in India to issue the electoral bond? So what is the right option here? So the right answer is State Bank of India. State Bank of India is authorized in India to issue the electoral bond as of December 2020. So let's see some important key points from this news. The government of India has announced that electoral bond will be issued by a state-run lender under 29 authorized branch of State Bank of India, and they will be available from 1st of Jan to 10th of Jan 2021. The next query is the electoral bond. Who can encash it? So it can be encashed only by an eligible political party through the bank account with the authorized bank. It is whom you are donating. For example, if I will donate an electoral bond to any political party, so they can encash it only through an authorized bank account. Now, who can buy an electoral bond? So electoral bond can be available individually, even you can buy it singly, or you can jointly with some other individual. Now, what is the validity period for this electoral bond? It is not like that. For example, if you draw a check, so it is valid for 3 months from the date which is written on the check. Now, what is with the electoral bond? So what is the validity? Again, an important question for you. So it is valid for 15 calendar days from the date of issue. Means today if it issued, so it is valid from today till 15 more days, and after that you can't claim any amount from the bank. So let's talk about State Bank of India. You know about State Bank. It is the largest public sector bank of India, and earlier it was known as Imperial Bank of India, and in 1955 when it was founded, so it was named as State Bank of India. So the date is very important for you. Whenever you will go for SBI clerk or SBI PO examination, so they can ask you the date also. So when it was founded, so it was founded on 1st of July 1955. So where is the headquarter located? So headquarter is Mumbai. It is very easy because if you will prepare for banking examination, no? So different headquarters are located in Mumbai only, so it is very easy for you. Few banks are there whose headquarters are located in Kolkata or in Delhi, but maximum you will see in Mumbai only. Who is the chairperson at present? The incumbent is Dinesh Kumar Khara. So let me tell you something more about this news. So SBI. So SBI is the 43rd largest bank in the world. So it is not only the largest public sector bank in India, even it is ranked in the world. So it is the 43rd largest bank in the world, and it was also ranked 221 in the Fortune Global 500 list of world biggest corporation in 2020. So date is important for you, the rank it is important for you, 221 in the Fortune Global 500 list of the world biggest corporation of 2020. So all this was about SBI. So let's move to the next question. The next question here is, which bank partnered with RuPay to launch RuPay POS? POS here means point of sale machines, point of sale, in association with Pay Nearby distributor to transform smartphone into merchant point of sale terminal. Now here are some key points for you. What is point of sale? Point of sale is a machine. Okay, so whenever you will visit to a store to make some purchases, and if you want to pay online with the help of a credit card or debit card, even nowadays you can make a contactless payment with the help of point of sale machines because they are NFC enabled. So whenever you will swipe your card, you can see a machine, it is type a ATM machine. Okay, so a small machine is there, so you have to swipe your card here, so it is known as point of sale machine. Now RuPay has partnered to launch an initiative to innovate the smartphone, means it will transform your smartphone into merchant point of sale machines. I mean that if somebody who possesses a mobile phone and if it is NFC enabled, so now they can transform their mobile phone into a merchant point of sale machine. Earlier what is happening, that if you want to make digital payment, if you want to accept digital payment, so the merchant, he need to buy the machine from the bank and they need to incur some additional charges. So because of that only, whenever you will swipe your card in any store, so they ask, they levy certain charges. They said that there are some maintenance charges, 1%, 2%, which goes to the bank. So now it is very easy even for the small merchant, if they want to receive the payment from their customers, so they can do even with your smartphone. Now they can transform the smartphone. So with whom it is done, by which bank? So it is done by RBL Bank. So let's see some important points from this news. So the international card payment service RuPay, so RuPay, you know, it's an Indian payment gateway, which so it has partnered with which bank? With RBL Bank to launch an innovative payment solution. Now what it they will do for Indian merchant in association with Pay Nearby. So all these are points which are important for you. RuPay point of sale in association with Pay Nearby, and it is done by RBL Bank. So the next here is the announcement. Who made the announcement? The announcement was made by National Payment Corporation of India. Now what is National Payment Corporation of India? Basically, National Payment Corporation of India is an umbrella organization who for operating retail payment and settlement system in our country, and it is fully owned by the Reserve Bank of India, which is the central bank, you all know. The next step, now what the collaboration will do? The collaboration will transform the smartphone into merchant point of sale machine. Now you don't need to buy additional machine for that. You can transfer your mobile phone only if it is NFC, near field communication. What is the full form NFC? It is a near field communication which is used to make connection between a near distance between devices. The smartwatches, you have seen, it works with NFC. The headphones, Bluetooth earphones, now it is NFC enabled, so even you can connect with NFC. In the same way, the contactless credit card and debit card, they also functions with NFC. So there are different multiple use of NFC. So in the same way, now you can transform your smartphone into merchant point of sale machine. Now what is the payment which the merchant can receive from the customer? So the there's upper limit, so they can make a contactless payment up to rupees 5000. Okay, so it's a contactless acceptance of payment, and the upper limit is rupees 5000. Now let's talk about RBL. So what is RBL Bank? The MD and CEO is Viswahir Ahuja. The headquarters is located in Mumbai, Maharashtra, and the tagline is Apno Ka Bank. And there is also a chatbot of RBL Bank, so the name is RBL Care. Now what is chatbot? Chatbot is basically an artificial intelligent designed robot. What they do, for example, you know, owing to COVID-19, the call center of the bank were closed. Now if you have any query, where you will go? So now the bank, they have upgraded their infrastructure, and now you can also interact with the robot. So what is the chatbot of the RBL Bank? The name is RBL Cares. In the same way, HDFC also have their own chatbot. So all these were important updates from this news. So let me tell you something more about National Payment Corporation of India. So it was established in 2008, and who is the chairman? The chairman name is Biswa Mohan Mahapatra. So it is important for you. Biswa Mohan Mahapatra is the chairman of National Payment Corporation of India. And who is the MD and CEO of NPCI? So the name is Dilip Asbe. Okay, so all these are important updates from this news. So let's move to the next question. Now the next question here is, an index was launched by RBI, name is Digital Payment Index. So what was the base year set by RBI to measure growth in digital or cashless transaction in India for its Digital Payment Index DPI? So again, abbreviation which is important for you, that what is DPI? So the full form is Digital Payment Index. Now an index which is, you know about the different index which are launched from time to time. Some are international, some are national. Like if I say ease of doing business, which Andhra Pradesh is leading. So in the same way, there are different indexes which are launched. Human Capital Index, Human Development Index. So it is an index which is launched by RBI. What is the motive? To measure the growth of digital or cashless transaction in India. You know, Modi government has started an initiative of Digital India. So now you know the people, they are shifting toward digital transactions. And even in COVID also, all the stores were closed. So the people were making online purchases, and if you make online purchases, so there you can't make physical payment, so you have to make the payment with the help of your card. So there are different platforms with which you can do. Now this index is basically about debt only. So what is the base year for debt? You know about the base year. If I talk about national income, so when you will compare with something, so you need to have a parameter in your mind. So there is a base year on which basis the RBI has launched the Digital Payment Index. Now what is the base year? The base year is 2018. So 2018 is the base year for Digital Payment Index. Now let's see some key points from this news. On January 1st, 2021, the Reserve Bank of India introduced RBI Digital Payment Index. Now what was the motive? To measure the growth in digital or cashless transaction across the country. Now it was released on the lines of Statement on Developmental and Regulatory Policy as the part of 6th bi-monthly monetary policy, which was launched in the month of February 2020. The next year is, what is the base year which is important for you? So for the Digital Payment Index, the base year was 2018. It was the first Digital Payment Index which was released by RBI. Now from March 2021, the Digital Payment Index will be available on the website of RBI on semi-annual basis, means twice in a year. So let's see what are the parameters which are covered under Digital Payment Index. So there are five basically broad parameters which are going to be covered. So there are different weight which is assigned to this parameter. So payment enabler are assigned with 25%, payment infrastructure is assigned with 10%, payment infrastructure supply side factor are assigned 15%, and 10% is demand side factor. Payment performance is 45%, so it is maximum. So you should remember the payment performance, because the maximum weight is assigned to payment performance. And the last is consumer centricity, so it is assigned 5% weight. So now see what are covered under this parameter. So it is there in the next slide. So under payment enabler means how you can make the payment, who enables the payment. So it is internet, mobile phone, Aadhaar, bank account, participant and merchant. So all these are payment enabler, means they enable us to make the payment. If you want to make digital payment, so how you will be enabled? With the help of a mobile phone, with the help of internet, with the help of Aadhaar card. So all this, if you will purchase all these things, then only you are enabled to make the payment. Now payment infrastructure from demand side. Now demand is for whom? Demand is from the customer. So what the customer do? They used to make the payment with the help of debit card, the credit card, the prepaid instrument, and customer registered mobile and internet banking and the FASTag. So all these are demand side, and which is demanded by the customer of the bank. Now payment infrastructure supply side, it is assigned 15% and demand side is assigned 10%. Now what is the difference here? So let me tell you about the supply side sector. Now the supply side sector, it is provided by who supply? The bank supply. So what they supply? They supply as different bank branches in rural and even in the urban area. Business correspondent, like they have different business partners. The ATMs, the point of sales terminal, which is located in different stores. The QR code, it is also given by the bank. You know about the QR code of Paytm, the phone pay which you have to scan, the Google Pay QR code, and the intermediaries which works with different bank. Now the next parameter is payment performance. Now it is assigned 45% maximum. So it is important for you. Now, what is the payment performance? What covers under it? The digital payment system volume, the digital payment system value. Volume means how many people are doing the payment, and digital payment system value means what is the transaction amount which is made. The unique users who are doing the paper clearing mechanism, currency in circulation, and the cash withdrawal which is done by the different customers. Now, what is consumer centricity? The consumer centricity, it has the minimum weight and it is assigned with 5%. Now, what is covered under consumer centricity? The awareness and education to the consumers about digital transaction. How many declines are there? You see, the HDFC Bank, it is in limelight because the RBI has sent an internal audit for the digitalization, digital banking of HDFC. Often you see the services are clashing. Now, how many declines are there in your payment system? You know about Google Pay, it is also facing the same problem. How many complaints are filed by the consumers to the RBI or the ombudsman or to different redressal forum of the bank? How many frauds are recorded? It is going on. Okay, and what is the system downtime? So all these are different parameters and sub parameters which are considered under the digital payment index, and it is one of the most important question for your upcoming examination. So you should remember each and every fact, and if you are especially preparing for RBI grade B examination, so this question is 100% important for you. For let's move to the next question. The next question here is, which organization signed a $231 million loan agreement with Indian government for the construction of Lower Kopali hydroelectricity power plant in Assam? Now, a power plant was set up in Assam. The name of the power plant is Lower Kopali hydroelectric power plant in Assam. Now, which organization has signed a loan agreement? So the amount is also important for you. $231 million loan agreement, and it is done with Asian Development Bank. Now let's see some key points from this news. So Asian Development Bank and the government of India, they have signed a $231 million loan agreement for the Assam Power Sector Investment Program. So investment program was there of Assam power sector, so it is done basically for that, for the construction of Lower Kopali hydroelectric power plant. So the full form is again important for you. Now, what is the main purpose? It is important. It is very important. Now, what there are certain objective if a state or if any organization do. So the main objective of the loan agreement is to increase the electricity generation capacity in the state of Assam through construction of 120 megawatt hydroelectric power plant over the Kopali river. So a river is there named Kopali. So a 120 megawatt hydroelectric power plant will be set up over that river. Now, what the hydroelectricity project, it will increase availability of electricity for household. Now the household who don't have electricity, so now it will make electricity availability possibility for those household. The project will also increase the electricity supplied from clean energy by 469 gigawatt hours by 2025 and reduce greenhouse gas emission by 3.6 lakh tons of carbon dioxide annually. So you know the government want to adopt sustainable energy, clean energy, so that they can eradicate the greenhouse gas emission, so carbon dioxide basically. So with the help of that, they can achieve the target of 469 gigawatt hours by 2025. Now, Assam is in news, so it is an important state. It's a part of Seven Sisters. So Assam capital is Dispur, and the chief minister is Sarbanand Sonowal. Who is the governor? The governor is Jagdish Mukhi, and there are different national parks in Assam. So the very important one is Kaziranga National Park. It is famous for one-horned rhinoceros. It is famous for. The next is Manas National Park, Dibru Saikwa National Park, Nameri National Park, and Orang National Park. And again, Assam is in news. So some important bridges are there which are situated in Assam. So let me tell you the name of the bridge. They are the longest bridge. So the first name here is Dhola Sadia Bridge. Dhola Sadia Bridge. So it is the longest bridge in our country, and the length of this bridge is 9.15 kilometers, and the river over which it is located, so it is located over Brahma पुत्र रिवर. नाउ व्हेन इट वाज कंस्ट्रक्ट व्हेन इट वाज इनॉग्रेटेड बाय नरेंद्र मोदी, सो लेटर लेटर ऑन इट वाज रीनेम्ड. सो इट वाज रीनेम्ड आफ्टर भूपेन हाजोरिका, भूपेन हाजरिका. सो नाउ इट इज नोन एज भूपेन हाजरिका ब्रिज एंड इट इज वन ऑफ द लॉन्गेस्ट ब्रिज ऑफ इंडिया एंड इट इज बिल्ड ओवर ब्रह्मपुत्र रिवर. सो भूपेन हाजरिका इज अ रेनाउंड सिंगर फ्रॉम असम एंड ही वॉज ऑल्सो फेलिसिटेटेड विद द भारत रत्न अवॉर्ड इन 2019 विद टू मोर स्कॉलर्स हु रिसीव्ड. सो all these were important update from Assam. Again one more bridge which was inaugurated there, and let me tell you something more about that bridge. So the what's the name of the bridge? The name was Bhogi Bil Bridge. So Bhogi Bil Bridge is also located in Assam. So it is a combined road cum rail bridge. So if the question arises that which is the longest bridge in our country, so you will say the Bhupen Hazarika Setu Bridge over Brahmaputra River. And if the question arises that which is the double decker road cum rail bridge, the longest in India, so the name is Bhogi Bil Bridge and it is also located over the Brahmaputra River. So all these are important updates from this news. So let's move to the next question. The next question here is, which bank received rupees 5,500 crores in zero coupon bond from central governments for its recapitalization on January 2021? Now a bank which has received some funds from the government in the form of zero coupon bond for recapitalization in January. So what's the name of the bank? The name is Punjab and Sindh Bank. So now let's see some important key points from this news. It is a first kind of move by the central government which has issued rupees 5,500 crore in zero coupon bond to recapitalize the Punjab and Sindh Bank by allowing it to park the paper in its held to maturity HTM. The full form is important for you. Now what is HTM? Now HTM here means that the securities, the bonds, they are purchased, they should be owned until maturity. Means the bank can't invest it anywhere, okay, for any kind of profit from it. Means they need to held it until maturity. So held to maturity means, so full form is important for you. So the amount is again important for you, and the bank Punjab and Sindh Bank is important for you because it is a first kind of initiative by the central government in which face value rather than discounted market price. Means the zero coupon bond, they are issued at the face value rather than discounted market price. Now what is the face value and what is discounted market price? I will tell you later on. So these bond are non-tradable. Means the lender has to kept them in STM bucket. And I have told you about the STM bucket, held to maturity bucket. Means they can't use it for any other profit. They have to held all the bonds until maturity. Means they can't use it for any market gain or loss from this bond. The next here is, what is held to maturity? So I have already discussed about it. Now what is zero coupon recapitalization bond? Now first question arise here is, what is zero coupon? Coupon here means the rate of interest which the investor will get on this bond. Zero coupon means there is no interest on this bond. So if there is no interest on this bond, why the investor they are going to invest on this bond? Now this bond are issued at discount rate, okay, and at the maturity they are redeemed at par. So that is the profit of the investor. Means they will be issued at discount, and when they will be redeemed, they will redeemed at par. So that will be only the profit of the investor. Now it is the first time that all the bonds are issued at the fresh value rather than discounted market price. So that's why this question is important for you, and all the updates from this news I have already discussed with you. So remember all the key points, note it down in their copy. Let's discuss about Punjab and Sindh Bank when it was established. So it was established in 1908. Who is the managing director and chief executive officer? It's S. Krishnan. And the tagline here is, where service is a way of life. And the headquarters is located at our capital of India. It's New Delhi. Let's move to the next question. The next question here is, which organization partnered with Jammu and Kashmir government to launch health insurance coverage under आयुष्मान भारत प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना अ सोशल एंडेवर फॉर हेल्थ एंड टेली मेडिसिन. नाउ दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू. व्हाट इज प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना? व्हाट इज सेहत? सो आई विल टेल यू ईच एंड एवरीथिंग. बट व्हिच इज द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विथ हुम जम्मू एंड कश्मीर गवर्नमेंट हैज पार्टनर? सो द नेम इज बजाज आलियंस जनरल इंश्योरेंस. सो नाउ सी सम इंपॉर्टेंट की पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम हियर. सो बजाज आलियंस जनरल इंश्योरेंस हैज एसोसिएटेड विद जम्मू एंड कश्मीर गवर्नमेंट टू लॉन्च द हेल्थ कवरेज अंडर आयुष्मान भारत प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना. दिस एब्रिविएशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू अप्स एंड डिफरेंट एग्जामिनेशन. Under Sehat, Social Endeavor for Health and Telemedicine. So both the full forms are important for you. Now, when this scheme was launched, so it was launched by Narendra Modi in December 26, 2020. And the scheme, what it provides universal health insurance cover to all the citizens of JNK, and it also ensures some financial securities benefit under medical emergency. Now, this is the first time that any scheme in India is implemented to such huge masses. So it is happening for the first time. So all the key points are important for you for Pradhan Mantri Jan Aragya Yojana. Now let me tell you something about the Pradhan Mantri Jan Aragya Yojana. What it is basically? So it is a program by the Indian government under National Health Policy. Okay. So the scheme was launched by the Modi government in the month of September in 2018. प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. सो इट इज बेसिकली अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम व्हिच इज जॉइंटली फंडेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट प्लस द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. सो इट इज अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम एंड बाय दिस स्कीम द गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट टू रीच 50 crore 500 million ऑफ पीपल एंड इट इज द वर्ल्ड लार्जेस्ट गवर्नमेंट स्पॉन्सर्ड हेल्थ केयर प्रोग्राम. सो ऑल द की पॉइंट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू. नाउ व्हाट इज द बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव? सो द प्रोग्राम वॉज लॉन्च फॉर पॉवर्टी एलिवेशन फॉर द लो इनकम ग्रुप इन इंडिया बिकॉज यू नो द चार्जेस ऑफ हेल्थ केयर एंड मेडिकल एमरजेंसी इन इंडिया. सो बिकॉज ऑफ डेट दिस एंडेवर वाज टेकन बाय द मोदी गवर्नमेंट इन 2018. सो इन द ईपीएफ एग्जामिनेशन दिस काइंड ऑफ सोशल सिक्योरिटी स्कीम्स कैन बी आस्क्ड. नाउ व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ सेहत? इट इज सोशल एंडेवर फॉर हेल्थ एंड टेलीमेडिसिन. नाउ व्हाट इज सेहत? सेहत इज बेसिकली अ टेलीमेडिसिन हेल्थ इनिशिएटिव व्हिच इज लॉन्च्ड ऑन इन द ईयर ऑफ 2015 बाय रविशंकर प्रसाद हु इज द इनकम्बेंट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ लॉ एंड जस्टिस. नाउ इट इज लॉन्च इन कोलाबोरेशन विथ अपोलो. मीन्स सेहत वॉज लॉन्च इन कोलाबोरेशन विथ अपोलो एंड इट इज द फर्स्ट टेली मेडिसिन सेंटर विच वॉज लॉन्च इन इंडिया. ओके. नाउ व्हाट इट ऑफर्स बेसिकली? सो सेहत इज ए इनिशिएटिव विच वॉज लॉन्च टू ऑफर टेली मेडिसिन सेंटर इन रूरल एरिया ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ व्हाट द पीपल ऑफ द रूरल एरिया दे कैन डू? नाउ दे कैन कंसल्ट द डॉक्टर ऑनलाइन with the help of phone calls for their genetic drugs. Now, if anyone needs any kind of help in some medical emergency, so now with the help of Sehat Initiative, which is named as Social Endeavor for Health and Telemedicine, so they can consult the doctors online, okay? And for these different common service centers, which was launched with the support of Apollo and Medanta Hospital Telemedicine Service, so all these were important updates from Sehat. So I think all the key points are important to you. So let's move to some static fact about Bajaj Allianz General Insurance Company. So who is the MD and CEO of Bajaj Allianz General Insurance Company? The name is Tapan Singhal and the way is the headquarter located. So it is located in Pune, Maharashtra. Let's move to the next question. Which organization partnered with SIDBI to provide financial assistance to MSME to engage in rooftop solar power production in January 2021? Now SIDBI has partnered with a company. Now what is the motive? It was just done to provide a financial scheme to the micro, small and medium enterprises so that they can engage in rooftop solar segment. Now it is done with the Tata Power. So Let's see some important key points from the news. So Tata Power partnered with SIDBI. SIDBI is important for you. Small Industrial Development Bank of India, and IDBI stands for Industrial Development Bank of India. What they will do? They will provide a financial scheme to the micro, small and medium enterprises. So full form of MSME is also important for you to engage in rooftop solar segment. So all the with whom? The first question is with Tata Power. The second, with which bank? SIDBI. What is the motive to provide financial scheme to the MSME sector? Now, for what? To engage in rooftop solar segment. So there are four questions which can arise from a single topic. Now what they will do? They will overcome the financial barrier for penetration of solar system in the MSME sector. Now with the help of debt, now the MSME, they can get the financial benefit without any collateral at an interest rate which is less than 10%. Collateral means any security. If you will go to the bank for any loan, okay, so the bank will ask for any collateral. If you will go for gold loan, you have to keep the gold with the bank and they will sanction the loan. Now, what is the motive? I have already discussed. Now, the MSME can adopt sustainable energy for their business, and you know it is economical, okay, and they can save their money also, and it also beneficial for the environment. Now, let me tell you something about the SIDBI, which is important for you. So, when was SIDBI established? It was established in 1990. The headquarters is located in Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. Important for you because there are few headquarters of a bank which are located in UP. And who is the MD? The MD is Manoj Mittal, and V. Satya Venkata Rao. So all these were key points from this news. Let's move to the next question. Which financial entity recently signed a loan agreement worth $105 million to the government of India for the development of inland water transport in West Bengal in January 2021? Now, which financial entity has signed an agreement with the West Bengal government for the inland water transport in January 2021? So the right option here is World Bank. Now, World Bank, you know, it is very important for you. It's the international financial organization. So I will tell you about it. So now let's discuss what is the motive behind this collaboration. So the government of India has signed an agreement with World Bank for $105 million for the West Bengal inland water transport logistic and spatial development project. Now, what is the objective of this project? So the objective here is to improve the inland water transport infrastructure in Kolkata, West Bengal. So you know Kolkata is a very historic place in India. Now what it will do? It will improve the efficiency and safety of passengers and freight movement across the Hooghly River. A question will arise. Kolkata city is located near which river? So it is beside the Hooghly River. So let's see something about World Bank. Now, when the World Bank was created, it was created in 1944 under Bretton Woods Conference along with the IMF. You know about the IMF, International Monetary Fund. So it was created under Bretton Woods Conference in 1944. Where is the headquarter located? Washington, D.C., United States. Who is the president? So the incumbent, David R. Malpass. So the World Bank is an international financial institution which provides loan and grant to the government of low and middle income countries. Now what is the purpose? The purpose is to finance the capital project of that country. Now the World Group, it comprises of two institutes. So the first one is IBRD, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, and the next one is IDA, International Development Association. So the World Bank is a component of the World Bank Group. Now let me tell you something about the state of West Bengal. So who is the Chief Minister of West Bengal? So the Chief Minister here is Mamata Banerjee, and who is the Governor? So the Governor is Jagdeep Dhankar. Let's move to the next question. The next question here is RBI announced introduction of LEI, Legal Entity Identifier, for all transaction worth rupees 50 crore and above undertaken through RTGS and NEFT effective from 1st of April 2021. So what does LEI stands for? So what is the full form of LEI? So the full form here is Legal Entity Identifier. The Reserve Bank of India announced the introduction of Legal Entity Identifier for whom? For all the payments of transaction which are 50 crore and above. So the amount is important for you, 50 crore and above, undertaken by entities through real-time gross settlement, the full form of RTGS, real-time gross settlement. So there are different online payments like NEFT, IMPS, and National Electronic Fund Transfer effective from 1st of April 2021. Now, what is legal legal entity identifier? So it is basically a 20-digit global reference number. Now what it will identify? It will identify all the legal entities participating in the financial transaction. It makes the identification of entity easy in the global database. So it will identify all the legal entities which takes part in the digital transactions. It will act as a key measure to improve the quality and accuracy of financial data system for better risk management, and it maintains all the records of rupees 50 crore and above through RTGS and NEFT. Means all the transactions which are equal to 50 crore or more than 50 crore, which is done through RTGS, real time gross settlement, and National Electronic Fund Transfer. So it is going to identify all the transactions. So what is the motive behind it? So motive is just to manage the risk management in online banking system. Now, what is the responsibilities of the bank with regards to LEI? So now the bank will advise entities to acquire LEI, means legal entity identify number, if they don't possess, and it will also record all the transaction of rupees 50 crore and above, which is done through RTGS and NEFT. Now, the LEI, it can be obtained from any local operating units accredited by global umbrella organization named Global Entity Identifier Foundation, based in Basel, Switzerland. So all these are key points from this news. So the full form of LEI is important from you. It is a 20-digit global reference number. So what is the motive and what is the transaction? So you should remember each and everything. Let's move to the next question. The next question here is, which bank recently signed a MOU with Indian Army to provide the service account Shorya salary account in January 2021? Now, a memorandum of understanding was signed with the Indian Army by a bank, and the name of the account is Shorya salary account. So what, with which bank it is done? So it is done with Bandhan Bank. So let's see some important updates from this news. So what are the benefits under Shorya salary account? So the memorandum of understanding is signed with Indian Army for the Bandhan Bank Shorya salary account. Now, the facility is available to which army personnel? So the serving personnel of Indian Army, means not the retired who are serving in the Indian Army. So they can open the account across any branch of Bandhan Bank in our country. It's a zero balance salary account, so it is not a savings account, it's a salary account in which you will get a 6% interest on the balance above rupees 1 lakh. So again, a lucrative interest rate on the savings of more than 1 lakh rupees. Now, what are the key features? So the key features here are unlimited ATM and other transactions. Whenever you will make ATM transaction, when you will withdraw money from your ATM, so there are limits. You can make 4 transactions in a month, and if you will go to different outlets, so suppose if you possess a ATM card of SBI, okay, and if you go to withdraw money from ICICI ATM, so there are certain charges which are levied by the bank after a particular limit of transaction which you make. Now, if you will avail a Shorya account, so unlimited ATM and other transaction can be made with the Bandhan Bank ATM as well as the ATM of other bank. Now, the next here is, you will get a free of charge Shorya Visa Platinum debit card through which you can make online transaction. And you know, whenever a bank issue a debit or credit card, certain charges are levied annually, so the charges are also waived off. So it's a free of charge Shorya Visa Platinum debit card. You are also entitled to insurance cover, means you will also get a personal accident insurance of rupees 30 lakh rupees, and you will also get air accident cover of rupees 1 crore. So let's see some static fact about Bandhan Bank. So the CEO is Chandrasekhar Ghosh, and the headquarters is located at Kolkata, and when it was founded in 2001. So all these were key points from this news. Let's move to the next question. The next question here is, who will chair the advisory council that will be responsible for managing the implementation of RBI's payment infrastructure development fund scheme? Now, a payment infrastructure development fund was established by RBI. It's a scheme was there. Now, who will chair the advisory council? So it will be chaired by the deputy governor of RBI, B.P. Khanungu. Full form is Bipu Prasad Khanungu. So he's one of the RBI deputy governor. So let's see what they are going to do with this fund. So Reserve Bank of India announced the operationalization of a payment infrastructure development fund PIDF scheme with an initial corpus of rupees 345 crore for 3 years starting from 1st of Jan 2021, and it may also extend it for 2 more years depending upon the progress. Now, what the advisory council under the chairmanship of RBI Deputy Governor Bibhu Prasad Kanungo, it will be responsible for managing the function of a PIDF, means a Payment Infrastructure Development Fund. Because this scheme was launched by RBI. Now, there are certain objectives of this scheme. So, what are the objectives? So, the objective here is to increase the number of payment acceptance device in the country. Now, what is the meaning of payment acceptance device? You know, whenever you will make some payment, so you need the ATM teller machine. Whenever you will make payments through Paytm, so you know digital wallet. So there are different payment acceptance devices in our country. So they will increase so that they can give boost to the digital payment in India. The next here is, the scheme also aims to create payment acceptance infrastructure in tier 3 to tier 6 cities with a special focus on northeastern states. So you know about the seven sisters. Now, what the scheme is going to cover? So the scheme will cover multiple payment acceptance device and infrastructure supporting card payments, such as the point of sale machines, point of services, M point of sales, GPRS general pack radio service, and QR code based payment system. So you know, today you can make digital payments through Paytm, also through Google Pay, through phone pay. There are different platforms, through point of sale machines, even you can transform your mobile phone, you can make contactless payments. So this fund was basically designed so that the payment acceptance device in the country can be increased, the infrastructure of payment acceptance in the tier 3 to tier 6 cities can also be improved, so that the people, they can make their payments with zero declines, so that the RBI can facilitate digital services for the user. So all these were important updates from the news. So let's move to the next question. Which bank recently signed two loan agreement worth $646 million with the government of India and government of Andhra Pradesh in January 2021? Now, a loan agreement was signed, what is the amount? It was $646 million with the government of India and a state government of Andhra Pradesh in January. So what's the name of the organization? So it was done with the New Development Bank, which is also known as BRICS Bank. So let's see some updates from the news. The government of Andhra Pradesh and the New Development Bank NDB signed two loan agreement worth $646 million for two projects. Now there are two projects, so that each project it will get a fund of $323 million, and it is funded by the National Development Bank. Now what the project are for? So the project are basically to upgrade the state highway and the road, and to reconstruct all the obsolete bridges of the state, so that they can improve the traffic problem in the state, and they can improve the infrastructure of road and bridges in the state. So you can see the two projects include Andhra Pradesh Road and Bridge Reconstruction Project and Andhra Pradesh Mandal Connectivity and Rural Connectivity Improvement Project. So it is basically for the infrastructure of the state highways and the bridges, so that they can improve the problem of heavy traffic in the state, and they can mix the situation easy for the people of Andhra Pradesh and the citizens of our country. So let's see something about the New Development Bank. So the New Development Bank, during the 6th BRICS summit in Fort Zilla 2014, the leader of all the BRICS nations, they signed an agreement to establish NDB, which was earlier known as BRICS Bank. So when it fully came into operation, it was came on 27th of February 2016, which is the headquarter of NDB, National Development Bank. So headquarters is located at Shanghai, China, and formerly it was referred as BRICS Development Bank. So the full form is often asked in examination. What is the full form of B? Brazil, R for Russia, I for India, C for China, and S for South Africa. Earlier it was BRICS, so South Africa joined it later on, so it became BRICS. Who is the president? So the president here is Marcos Theajo, which is again important for you because earlier the president of NDB was an Indian, KV Kamat, on whose recommendation the one-time restructuring program to the debt-ridden MSME was given by the RBI. So I will tell you in the next question. So Andhra Pradesh is in news. So the governor of Andhra Pradesh is Biswa Bhushan Harichandra and the chief minister is Y.S. Jagmohan Reddy. So all these were important updates from Andhra Pradesh and NDB. The next question is, which bank recently signed an MOU with SIDBI enabling MSME customers to apply online for one-time restructuring in January 2021? So the name here is Bank of Baroda. With Bank of Baroda, SIDBI has signed a memorandum of understanding which will enable the MSME customer to apply online for one-time restructuring in January 2021. Now, one-time restructuring, what it is basically? So let's discuss. The Bank of Baroda signed an MOU with SIDBI, Small Industrial Development Bank of India, to enable micro, small and medium enterprises customer so that they can apply online for OTR. OTR full form is important for you, one time restructuring. Now what they will do, it will help the MSME entities which have a credit exposure up to rupees 25 crore, means they can restructure their loan with the help of a web-based portal named Asset Restructuring Module for MSME. So the portal is again important for you, Asset Restructuring Module for MSME. Now, what is one-time restructuring scheme by RBI? You know, owing to COVID-19, certain people who used to opt out the EMIs and even the entrepreneurs and the MSME, they used to take a loan from the bank and which they have to repay in the form of EMIs. Now, owing to lockdown, everything was closed. So how they will pay the EMIs? So the debt-ridden MSME, they were given some facilities. Not only the MSME, even the normal people of our country, they can also entitle one-time restructuring. There were certain conditions of the bank. So on August 6th, 2020, RBI announced OTR scheme, which allow bank to restructure loans of borrowers that were regular in their repayment and who didn't have more than 30 days overdue as on March 1st, 2020. So this date is important for you. So OTR facility was available only to those users which amount was not overdue for more than 30 days as on March 1st, 2020. So this facility was also made available to the MSME entities who has a credit exposure of rupees 25 crore. And again, a next question which is important for you, on whose recommendation OTR framework was provided? So it was provided under the KV Kamath committee. So again, KV Kamath is important for you. He is the former NDB president, National Development Bank. Now let's talk about Bank of Baroda. So you know about the recent merger in the last financial year. Bank of Baroda. So Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank was merged with Bank of Baroda. So now three bank, they are covered under a single branch known as Bank of Baroda. So again, important for you, Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank, it is merged with which bank? So you know about the parent bank, it is Bank of Baroda. Who is the MD and CEO? Sandeep Chadha. Where is the headquarter located? It is located at Vadodara, Gujarat. Earlier it was known as Baroda. When Bank of Baroda was founded? It was founded on 20th of July 1908. And what's the tagline? It is India's international bank. So all these are important updates from Bank of Baroda. Let's move to the next question, and it's the last question. Which urban cooperative bank became the first to voluntarily convert into a scheduled commercial bank under RBI scheme on voluntary transition of urban cooperative bank into a small finance bank? Now a scheme was launched in which the urban cooperative bank, they can voluntarily transform them into a small finance bank. Now which is the first urban cooperative bank to do so? So the name here is Shivalik Mercantile Cooperative Bank. Now it has opted the scheme to transform into a small finance bank. So it is very important for you for your upcoming examination. So now let's see. So important key point. So the RBI has issued a scheduled commercial bank license to Shivalik Mercantile Cooperative Bank to carry the business as a small finance bank. So you know you need to get a license from the RBI if you want to work as a commercial bank. So what is the name of the scheme? The scheme name is Voluntarily Transition of Urban Cooperative Bank into a Small Finance Bank. This scheme was launched in 2015 as a part of financial inclusion, which gave a wider scope to urban cooperative banks so that they can transform them into a small finance bank and they can avail different benefits which are available to commercial bank. Now, it is the first urban cooperative bank in India to transit to SFF under the scheme. Now, Shivalik Mercantile Bank will be renamed as Shivalik Small Finance Bank and the bank expect to commence business from April 2021. Now, what is the voluntary transition of urban cooperative bank? I have already told you it is part of financial inclusion, which was launched in 2015, under which different banks were granted license as a small finance bank. Okay, and now it is the first urban cooperative bank which is transformed into a small finance bank, and the name is Shivalik Mercantile Cooperative Bank. Now, let me tell you something more about the Shivalik Small Finance Bank. The headquarters is located in Saharanpur, UP, and it commenced operation as a urban cooperative bank in 1998. Who is the MD and CEO? It's Mr. Suvir Kumar Gupta, and who is the chairman? It is Yashvahir Kumar Gupta. So all these are important updates from this for the month of January. So all these are top 15 MCQs from the month of January for banking awareness. So again, I will record a different session. So if you like my session, you can use my code Bhargav10 to buy the plus courses of Career Clouds. Download the app from the Play Store and you can avail the plus course of Affair Clouds, where you can daily master your current affairs with the help of Career Clouds team. Learn to lead. So don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel Affair Clouds, and if you have enjoyed the session, like my session and even share with your friends. We need your support to grow. So thank you all of you for watching the session. Take care. We'll get you with you in the next session.